Hello friends, this is Dr. Pradeep Ahuja here. In one of my previous videos on patient satisfaction, I had given you quite a few number of tips. So today I'll be discussing a vital parameter of patient satisfaction. What I believe is patient education plays a very important role, and there have been times that when patients have reported that their satisfaction began with the, say, perception of attentiveness by the dentist, the dignity, the respect offered, and an effective information transfer, or you may call it a communication between the dentist and the patient, and finally a shared decision making where the dentist actually told the patients about all the pros and cons and they both made a decision informed via the informed consent part of the patient. So ek clinic mein ट्रीटमेंट का क्या अल्टीमेट एम है? द अल्टीमेट एम इज़ टू हैव मोर पेशेंट्स एंड अर्न मोर मनी. वो इट विल ऑलवेज नॉट कम वाया न्यू पेशेंट्स. मैनी टाइम्स इट विल कम वाया रिपीट विजिट्स ऑफ योर ओल्ड पेशेंट्स, एंड योर ओल्ड पेशेंट्स बिकमिंग योर से VIP पेशेंट्स एंड सेंडिंग यू गुड अमाउंट ऑफ रेफरल्स. तो ये एक चेन प्रोसेस है. एंड हाउ डज इट स्टार्ट? लेंडिंग अ पेशेंट एयर to the patient, listening attentively without interrupting the patient. Remember, the patient has to be made special during the consultation part. It is not always that you continue to say look here and there while doing consultation with the patient, getting distracted via your WhatsApp message or your phone beep or your assistant asking you something in between the patient. The conversation between the two of you should be one-on-one and with due attention. Listening is unspoken caring. Sir William Osler ne a statement diya tha, and again Vince Lombardi made a statement: it takes months to find a customer and only a few seconds to lose one. Why it is important to pay attention to what the patient says? There are a few aspects in that. You are, the perfect guy for, or the perfect dentist for your patient. That is why he's chosen you as his or her dentist from 8 or 9 or 12 or 15, whatever number of dentists you have in your area. So in patient's eyes, you are the best. So definitely you don't need to blabber about it. If the patient says, main pani peeta hoon, thanda pani peene se mujhe relief milta, you know what it is. But you really don't need to blurt it out. Listen to it. Because there might be two reasons. We always try to jump on to the conclusion immediately and then say, I got it, better, main dekh leta. The patient will say, I didn't tell even my whole problem. He's jumping onto the treatment. Is he or she the right guy? Really? Whether I made a right decision to choose him as my dentist? That is where the first sign of, uncertainty comes in patient's mind. Secondly, why this is important? Because the patient might blurt out additional symptoms, and life is always full of surprises. You can't really take anything for granted. So there are a few ways where you can actually gain more attentiveness from the patient side. One of them is greeting the patients by their first name, usually, which is usually the breaking the ice part. Then sitting down face to face at parallel level. Patient standing or you standing on the top, making a level of difference, it sometimes doesn't set a good example. Then an eye-to-eye contact without your vision hovering anywhere. Then assuring touch or pat on the back or shaking hands, on a limited side. Then other aspects like your body posture, your body language, your verbal tone, these all will actually demonstrate the patient that you are actually paying attention to his or her chief complaint. Ultimate aim kya hai hamara? We have to make a correct diagnosis, and rephrasing what the patient has said or paraphrasing or repeating the last word or two of the patient so that we convey to the patient effectively that the communication transfer has been perfect and you, meaning the dentist, have understood the patient's problem very clearly and you can go on about the task of making your diagnosis. And remember, this is the first step towards ensuring the patient's repeat visits. I have, say, given another example in my first consultation as well. I have a book written on first consultation as well, so with co-author Dr. Vandana. So all these little aspects are going to make a big difference in your conversation or communication with the patient. Also, the more you talk to your patient, you get to actually judge the patient's intellect, the patient's understanding of your, say, conveying of the problem to him. So, and also lets you comprehend their ability to, say, perceive their problem in a way that it should be. So these are the various parameters which actually decide how much your patient, and these go a long way in deciding your patient satisfaction levels. Remember, we have to get rid of "I am the dentist, I know the best" syndrome in our practice. It has to be an informed consent from the patient side, and if the patient requests, it has to be shared decision making. And you can't really fool a patient in today's times. All of them are Google educated patients, and it is always wise to do a consultation which is say identifiable and verifiable at any step. Do not make a quick jump to the procedures without understanding the basic parameters of, say, patient's problem. So if I have to summarize this thing, patient satisfaction is a deadly combo of great clinical work along with awesome patient experience. And great clinical work will come only from a good diagnosis. And good diagnosis will only come from understanding the patient's chief complaint. So remember, the patient education plays a vital role. So thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. Stay tuned. I'll be back soon with a few of my other videos on practice management, medical legal and finance. If you like it, please say comment and share with your colleagues of dental fraternity. Thank you so much.